எங்கள் வாழ்வும் எங்கள் வளமும் மங்காத தமிழ் என்று சங்கே முழங்கு. வணக்கம். Thank you all for, you know, attending the first ever web conference in English on, you know, the father of Tamil Nadu, Sri MP Sivanyanam yesterday. This is just an initiative to, you know, to bring to light the supreme sacrifices of a true nationalist and a leader, you know, who not only fought for the, you know, for the Indian people against the British, but he also played a crucial role in the formation of Tamil Nadu state. I just wanted to ensure that the speech in English being delivered yesterday reaches a wider audience and people get to know the supreme sacrifices of this leader. Many of you had the opportunity to watch the live web conference yesterday. Some of you had gone through the video on YouTube, gave us a lot of feedback. Many of you have given me a call personally. Many of you have texted me with messages. A lot of suggestions came in, a lot of feedback came in. One of the feedbacks for me was primarily, you know, for me to take, you know, talk as a separate video about the battle for Chennai between Andhra Pradesh and Tamil Nadu state. I take that as an opportunity today to present to you, you know, the battle for Chennai. Primarily, my motive is to ensure that the current generation of this, in this city, in this state, get to know the true history about the, you know, what one of the battles that Chennai had underwent in determining to which state, you know, this city should be the capital, which sadly many of you are not aware. Chennai is known for a lot of things. You know, we call it as the Detroit of India. We call it as the India's health capital. We proudly say that it's the most visited city, you know, by foreigners in India. In terms of square kilometers, it's 1,189 square kilometers, say by 2020. You know, the population this year is expected to be around, say, 10 million. And we also proudly say that, look, you know, this is also IT, you know, hub of Asia as well. Yes, there's nothing to deny about that. And we all of us should be proud. We all of us should also be proud to know the history, the battle that, you know, our previous generation has fought to ensure that, you know, this city continued to be retained, you know, as the capital of Tamil Nadu. So Maposi comes into picture where he plays a crucial part here. You know, when there were certain voices being raised, you know, in the city, in Chennai, and also, you know, primarily in Andhra, where they were calling as, you know, raising slogans, Chennai Manade, which means Chennai is ours in Telugu. There was one man who led the charge from the Tamils, fought till the end, and he ensured that, you know, the city is with us today. And he gave them the counter slogan, Chennai Namade, which we proudly say as Chennai is ours in, you know, Tamil today. So he led the battle, as I said earlier. He ensured that, you know, this city stayed within Tamil Nadu. I'm going to detail a few, you know, events in the important part of, you know, the city's history and also the, you know, history of Tamil Nadu state as well. Let me rewind you back to, you know, year 1952. When Rajaji became the chief minister of the Madras state, in his first general meeting, you know, he had attended it in Marina Beach. I suspect that it's Sirani Arangam, where probably the 90s kids might have not have got the opportunity to see it. It's no longer there. It's been, you know, demolished. I suspect that that meeting should have been happened in Sirani Arangam. Maposi speaks in that general meeting and he voices the fact that himself and the party led by Maposi, which is Tamilisai Kazhagam, are primarily supporting Rajaji with the hope that, you know, Rajaji would implement a separate state for the Tamils with, you know, Tamil as its official language. But all this were happening, you know, the ask for a separate Andhra state, you know, the voices became louder, stronger. And there was a time where, you know, Potti Sriramalu went on an indefinite fast. For all of the younger generation to know who, you know, Potti Sriramalu is, he's a true Indian nationalist. He's a freedom fighter. He was part of Congress unit. He also went along with Maposi to, you know, to be jailed in Velo when they were fighting against the British. And he's a true Satyagrahi as well. So he went on an indefinite fast, you know, demanding for a quick implementation of Andhra state. What happens during this time is that Maposi meets Potti Sriramulu in person upon the request of other Andhra councillors in the Chennai Corporation. And he requests, you know, Potti Sriramulu to, you know, let go of the indefinite fast. Then he also gets to meet, you know, Andhra Kesari Prakasam, who was also observing a one-day fast in support for Potti Sriramulu. Some of the names which you would hear in this talk are legendary figures, not only in Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh, but well-known people in you know, in this country as well. So just wanted to, you know, underscore that. While this was happening, you know, Maposi speaks to Potti Sriramulu. He speaks to Prakasam. Prakasam has a demand, you know, for Maposi, where he asks Maposi to, you know, to at least have Chennai as a temporary capital for Andhra Pradesh state. But Maposi, you know, knowing the true fighter he is and, you know, the passionate Tamil he is, you know, he didn't, you know, agree to this request. Unfortunately, after a few days, you know, what happens is that Potti Sriramulu, you know, dies. And, you know, Maposi actually, you know, primarily blames the central government, you know, for not, you know, being quick in the implementation for a separate state for Andhra. Knowing that things would get out of hand, what Nehru does is he announces in the parliament that a separate state of Andhra would be formed in year 1950, later in the year 1952. He states that districts were predominantly where the Telugus are living, predominantly, you know, without any conflict, those states would be comprised to form a new state of Andhra. And he also mentions that, you know, Chennai would not be, you know, part of this new Andhra state. While this came as a good news for Maposi, he was primarily worried that the fact that, you know, there was no mention about a new capital for the new state being, you know, in this statement. So he had his own doubts there. In the Legislative Assembly, Maposi clearly argues in the assembly, you know, citing historical facts on why Chennai should be part of Andhra Pradesh. Maposi also was pretty upset with the Nehru statement that, you know, Chittoor is also being mentioned as a district where, you know, Andhra would be formed, because Maposi was primarily asking certain taluks of Chittoor to be part of Tamils, primarily, you know, that's south of, you know, Tirumalai, if I have to make you guys understand right now. So that was his ask. So the Nehru has made a statement. He formed a commission which was headed by Vanchu. Vanchu is a justice. He is also a well-renowned figure during those times. And he visits Chennai, you know, to sort out the formation of Andhra state. While this was happening, Maposi meets Vanchu, you know, in Raj Bhavan. He clearly states to him that at no point in time would the people of Tamil Nadu, you know, will allow Chennai to be part of, you know, the Andhra state. Either they would allow that to be allowed, you know, as a temporary, you know, capital for Andhra. At this point in time, you guys also should be aware that there was also a change in demand from Prakasam. Now he was pitching in for, you know, to be, you know, Chennai to be a temporary capital. He was also asking, you know, for the city to be split into two, where South Chennai becomes the capital of, you know, Tamil Nadu, North Chennai becomes the capital of Andhra Pradesh, or he wants Chennai to be a union territory. Ironically, there were certain educated classes during that time who were also supporting, you know, for the ask of Chennai to be a union territory as well. In terms of population, you know, you guys, the younger generation should understand the fact that, you know, there were around, say, 64-65% of people by population who were, you know, Tamils at that point in time. Telugu speaking people were probably around, say, 14%, you know, living in Chennai. And North Chennai also, you know, was primarily, you know, being, you know, lived with, you know, Tamil speaking people. So it wasn't a rightful ask from, you know, Prakasam and his colleagues. While all this was, you know, happening, Vanchu has, you know, met people in Chennai and he's left back to Delhi. There's actually a news which has been published in the, you know, the Chennai edition of Mail, which states that Vanchu has actually sent a recommendation to the center asking, mentioning that, Chennai can be a temporary capital of Andhra. Second, there should be one governor for both the states. And third, there should be one high court for, both these states. This came in as a rude shock for Maposi. He immediately rushes to Rajaji's house and, he, gives him the update on the news which has been published in the mail. Rajaji cites to Maposi that this might be possibly true, but he is also running out of words. And he doesn't have much to say except asking Maposi to intensify his, efforts to save Chennai. What you'd also see from, Maposi's Janadu Poratam book while detailing these events, he says that Rajaji met after a few days, he met Nehru in New Delhi, and Nehru was not in a clear position to talk about, this topic to him. And Rajaji underscores the point to him that if the center has plans to make Chennai as a temporary capital of Andhra, then he is no longer in a position to continue as the Chief Minister of Madras State, and he asks Nehru to find another suitable candidate. So Rajaji, once he returns back to Chennai, he goes back, talks to, Maposi again, and he mentions to Maposi that it's now up to Maposi to save Chennai, from being annexed with Andhra. So while all this is happening, I just wanted to also let you guys know that during 1953, early 1953, Thamizhalarsu Kazhagam also had its second general conference where they passed a unanimous resolution asking Chennai to be continuing as a, capital for Tamil Nadu. At no point in time they will allow Chennai to be functioning as a temporary capital for Andhra Pradesh. Now they would allow the city to be split into two separate, capitals for each state. Now allow Chennai to be a union territory, as I, I was mentioning earlier. Along with this, Maposi also ensures that, around 200, assembly members who are not from Andhra, sign a joint statement, and he sends it to Nehru, demanding for this resolution, what I mentioned right now. Along with that, you also have around, say, 30 odd parliamentarians, who also, released a joint statement supporting Chennai to be, continuing as a part of Tamil Nadu. So once Rajaji, coming back to, the update I gave you earlier, that, Raja, Maposi had, and, Rajaji had a discussion once Rajaji had met Nehru in New Delhi. Maposi had a clear plan being cut out on how to ensure that Chennai is actually saved within Tamil Nadu. One, he immediately goes and meets, M. A. Muthiah Chettiar, and he requests his support for, this cause. One, what happens is that there's several thousands of telegrams which were sent to, Lal Bahadur Shastri, pressing for, Chennai to continue as a, the capital of Tamil Nadu, not be annexed with Andhra or even given as a temporary capital. Second is Maposi brings an important resolution in Madras Corporation, very, very important in the history of the city, that I wonder how many people, do realize that. He brings an important resolution into Madras Corporation where he passing the resolution. He also ensures the resolution is being passed, citing that the, Madras as a city should continue to be, part of Tamil Nadu. At no point will they give this city to be a temporary capital or allow it to be a union territory. The resolution is passed unanimously with a majority into the corporation. Maposi cites that there was thousands of people from, Chennai who were into the Madras Corporation, to visit the historic session that happened. Once this is done, the resolution is also being sent to Prime Minister Nehru, the President of India, the Home Minister of India. It's also been sent to the Chief Minister of the state, Rajaji. And finally, after a week, Maposi gets to meet, the Central Minister at that time, T.T. Krishnamacharya, and he mentions that to Maposi that now Nehru has a, change of heart, and he did say that he wouldn't be in a position to go against the resolution of Madras Corporation members. Within a few days, Nehru passes, makes an important, announcement in the, assembly, in the parliament, I'm sorry. He mentioned that, new state of Andhra would be formed which is excluding Chennai. He mentions that the people of the assembly members of Andhra should determine a capital and should inform the central government by early July. He also mentions them to identify a suitable city to have a high court for Andhra function from there. And he also mentions that a commission or commissions would be formed to resolve any disputes in the border for the state. Not to forget, finally, he also mentions that Chennai court would function, high court would function as the high court for Andhra as well, until the a place is identified for Andhra High Court to function. So this is an historic event in the for this city, for this state. And there was just one person sadly who single-handedly led the battle. He fought till the end, and he made sure that this beautiful city, what we call a Singara Chennai, is with Tamil Nadu. We all are proud Chennaiyans today, and we need to salute Maposi on his 115th birthday anniversary. Otherwise, we may live in this city, but I don't think so. Chennai would have then been a part of Tamil Nadu. It might have been another state, and you may not be proudly speaking as a member of Chennai city, which is part of Tamil Nadu. Maposi is a genius by himself. He's a top class politician. He's a true politician. He's a true nationalist. I urge all of you, especially the students, the younger generation, school kids, take time, go through the information about what is available in the web, in YouTube about Maposi. Ask your parents to explain, narrate the supreme sacrifices about Maposi and sacrifices of other true leaders like Vavu Chidambaram, Kappalottiah Tambiran, and Subramanya Bharathiyar. So you get to understand about them. You would understand the roots of this state, our culture, our language. My last and humble request for the state government is to ensure that on 115th birthday anniversary of Maposi, I would request the state government to declare his birthday as Chennai Day, which would be a fitting tribute to this legend, who we call as this, South Indian Tagore of India. In my opinion, he should have been, at least given the Bharat Ratna or awarded the Nobel Prize, but that sadly didn't happen. At least I look forward for a day where this Chennai Day is celebrated on his birthday. Someday the center awards him a Bharat Ratna, and a memorial is actually formed in the name of this legend in the city, which becomes an iconic place, the Marina Beach or the other places which we are proud of right now. And several schools, several institutions should also be started in the name of Maposi, while we provide free kids, education to the kids, and also promote Tamil as a medium of instruction for education as well. Thank you for the patience and, hearing me out. I really appreciate that. It was, fantastic talking to you all.